So here's what we do. Here's what we do. Rory, you can give them the publicist answer.
I do give the publicist answer a lot.
Let Rory give y'all the publicist answer.
Hey.
And I'll give y'all the unemployed black man answer.
Speak it true, speak it true.
I'll just give the Migos answer and you can go from there. What are we at?
Scotty too hotty.
Alright, so my status is I haven't seen or spoken to him to the guy you asked about since our last day at the studio. For good, I think it's good that I did. I mean, today I'm in a different space. Back in February, March, Rory had to like talk to me, calm me down, my brother, a bunch of people in my life.
Talk to me nice.
Because what we went through, which I don't, a lot of people don't know, is me and Rory really didn't talk about what really, really, really happened. We kind of kept it like, we didn't want to keep it, we didn't want to make it messy and, you know, too catty. We didn't want to put out that response at all. But we saw narratives online starting to grow legs and people starting to feel like it was true. So I called Rory one day and I was like, yo, you know that people are starting to feel like this split is our fault. And he was like, yeah, I'm seeing it. So we decided to post a video that we posted, talk about everything. But just know what Rory and myself dealt with, nobody in this room would have dealt with.
Yo.
I promise you that. And it wasn't something that just happened one day. This was like 2 years like of shit. And it was like, you know, Rory, we knew we were being cheated. We knew that money was being taken from us. We knew that. But it got to a point where we were like, yo, listen, let's just fix this. And as friends, let's move forward and continue to grow the show and the business. And that was met with ego and narcissism. And, you know, I don't do well with that because I'm just from a different space. Once somebody starts yelling and sweating, that's nervous energy. And I'm sitting there cool. I'm like, fam, we just trying to fix something because we're friends and we're doing something dope that the people love. Let's fix it and move forward. But when you're in business with somebody that chased a certain level of fame as a solo artist and then they achieve that level of fame with their friends, they can't take that. And they don't sit with them well, so they feel like they deserve more. When we gave more, like if y'all knew what the contract was, me and Rory agreed to a crazy contract. And that wasn't enough, you still decided to take from us. So it was just like enough was enough, and we just couldn't deal with it no more. I couldn't deal with it, Rory couldn't deal with it, and we just had to move forward. But blessings to them.
Because tonight, we have a lot of rappers on the block.
Well, see, we didn't look at it like we bossed up on anybody. Like, Rory and myself, we already knew that if we decided to do our own thing, that, you know, we would see success out of it because we believe in each other. You know what I'm saying? Thank you, bro. You know, we believe in each other. And it's a better work environment here. So it's all good. It's not like, well, we don't look at it like we bossed up on anybody. We did what we did. We pivoted, made our own moves. This is our chapter. We're doing something different than that.
We moved how we always moved. Y'all just see it in a different light.
I mean, if that's how you feel, that's how you feel. I didn't say it.
First of all, we're not here for any of that shit. We're here for you guys. Yeah.